Hello students, as in our last video I have explained you the half story of chapter 3, what Lucy finds in the wardrobe. Today we will go through the complete story, but before that I will again repeat from the beginning. Peter, Suzanne, Edmund and Lucy were four children who were sent away from London during the terrible war. There were air raids and bombing in London, and London was not safe for young children. They stay with an old professor. The professor had messy hair, which not only covered his head but also most of his face. Lucy is scared with the old professor. Lucy is the youngest among all the four children. The children teased Lucy, who is always the most cautious among all of them. Lucy was so frightened that she decided to ignore them. Next morning, it was raining heavily. After taking breakfast, the children sat around and wondered what to do. They decided to explore the house. Peter suggested that they should explore the house. Lucy was still little unsure, but at last she also agreed. While exploring the house, the children came upon an empty room with a large wardrobe. But while the others move on, Lucy, the youngest, stays behind and opens the wardrobe door. She looks inside curiosity, and Lucy founds there fur coats hanging inside the wardrobe. The fur coats were so soft that Lucy was tempted, and Lucy find the fur coats so attractive that she began to rub her face against the fur coats. Now we will read ahead. Lucy stepped into the wardrobe. It was completely dark inside. She took a few more steps, expecting to feel the hard woodwork of the back of the wardrobe. However, all she felt was an empty space, which meant she could walk deeper into the wardrobe. As she walked, she felt something crunching. Crunching means the sound that is heard when something is crushed under her shoes. Her hands could feel something soft, chalky, and very cold. This is strange, thought Lucy. It was snow. So Lucy went inside the wardrobe. It was completely dark inside. As she took more steps inside the wardrobe, she was thinking that there would be a hard woodwork at the back of the wardrobe. But she feel an empty space, which means that she can walk deeper ahead inside the wardrobe. As she walk, she feel a sound of something when it is crushed, and that crunching sound was coming under from her shoes. Her hand could feel soft, chalky, and very cold things. Lucy thought it is very strange. It was snow. Now children, come to next page, page number 33. Lucy continued to walk. Soon, instead of the soft furs, something rough and prickly brushed against her face. Why, it is just like branches of trees, she exclaimed. Lucy walked ahead. Instead of soft fur, Lucy found something rough and prickly, touched something against her face. It was like branches of trees, Lucy exclaimed. Lucy shut her eyes tight, wondering if she was in a dream. When she opened her eyes, she saw a strange light a few meters away from where she stood. A moment later, she realized that she was standing in the middle of a forest. It was night and snowing heavily. Although Lucy was frightened, she was curious to know what lay ahead of her. Lucy closed her eyes tight, thinking that she is in a dream. As she opened her eyes, she saw a strange light coming from far away from where she was standing. A moment she realized that she was standing in the middle of a forest, and it was night time and snowing heavily. Although Lucy was afraid, she was curious too to know what is lay ahead of her. For an instant, she thought of turning back. She turned around and saw the door of the wardrobe through which she had entered. That was reassuring. Reassuring means making you feel less worried. If anything goes wrong, I can simply run back, Lucy thought to herself. She continued walking and soon she reached a lamppost. As she stood there wondering what to do next, she heard the sound of footsteps advancing towards her. Soon a strange creature came into sight. He was almost as tall. Lucy is standing in the middle of the forest. It is night time and snow is also falling. Lucy is fearful yet very excited. Lucy looks back and sees the wardrobe door, that if something went wrong, she can run back to the wardrobe and go back to the house. She continued walking and soon she reached a lamppost. Lucy reached a lamppost and she standing there and wondering what to do next, she heard the sound of footsteps coming towards her. Soon Lucy found that a strange creature coming towards her. Now children, come to next page, page number 34. As Lucy and he carried an umbrella over his head, he looked like a man with a goat's horns, ears, legs and tail. He was a fawn. Fawn is a god of the woods with a man's face and body and a goat's legs and horns. He wore a woolen muffler around his neck and his skin was rather reddish from the cold snow. Though he looked odd, he had a gentle face. In one hand, the fawn held the umbrella and in the other, he carried some parcels. It looked like he was busy shopping for Christmas gifts. On seeing Lucy, he was so shocked that all the parcels fell from his hands. Goodness gracious me, exclaimed the fawn. Lucy saw a strange man coming towards her and carrying umbrella over his head. The man looked like a man, but he is having goat's horn, ear, legs and tail. He was a fawn. He wore a woolen muffler around his neck and his skin was reddish in color because of cold snow. Though he looked odd, but he has a gentle face. Fawn held an umbrella and in the other hand he carried some parcels. As you can see in the picture also, that Lucy met a man with the legs of a goat and two horns on his head, carrying parcels and an umbrella. Lucy imagines that he has just finished doing his Christmas shopping. The creature is called a fawn. And when he sees Lucy, he was so scared that he drops all his parcels. On seeing Lucy, the fawn was so shocked that all the parcels fell from his hands, as you can see in the picture, children. And the fawn exclaims, "Goodness gracious me." So fawn was so surprised to see Lucy, and Lucy was also so surprised after seeing a strange man who is fawn. Lucy's actions show that she was courageous, curious and adventurous. At first, she feared the house and its long corridors, but she was bold enough to overcome her fears and enter the wardrobe and discover an entirely new world. She was all alone in the forest and she even met a fawn. So, children, you read the story once again from the beginning. Thank you.